Good morning to all. I am Sumangla, your maths teacher. Today we are learning maths for grade 4 ICC. Your textbook first chapter is large numbers. You have learned up to 4 digit number in 3rd standard. In this class we are learning 5 digits, 6 digits and 7 digits numbers. So let us record previous year's portion. The smallest 3-digit number is 100. The greatest 3-digit number is 999. The smallest 4-digit number is 1000. And the greatest 4-digit number is 9999. So, how we go to all those things? When we added 1 to this greatest number, we got the next smallest number. So, method is same. We are going to repeat 5 and 6, 7 digits numbers. So, up to here, up to 4, you have learned. That is your previous year's portion. So, now you concentrate in 5 digit number. That is, 5 digit smallest number is 10,000. How we got this number? Just we added 1 to this greatest 4 digit number. Then we got this number, that is 10,000. So same way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 digits are there. If we put 5 nines, so you will be getting your greatest 5 digit number. That is 99,999. Is it clear? Yeah, same way, add 1 more this, you will be getting next smallest number, that is 6 digit number. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 unit, tens, 100, thousands, 10,000, 1 lakh. How to read this number? 1 lakh. We reach in 6th place, that is your lakh place. Next is the greatest 6 digit number. Same way, put 6 nines, 6 nines, and try to read this number, that is unit, tens, 100, thousands, 10,000 and lakh. How to read? 9,99,999. Okay, I know it will be lengthy this one. So, by writing in words, you have to write like this. So, this also will become another thing that we will discuss later. Now, come to our point. 7 digits number, same way, add 1 with this greatest 6 digit number, you will be getting 7 digit smallest number, that is your 10 lakh. Which place we reached? We reached on our 10 lakhs place, that is our 7th smallest place. Now we are moving to a city's friend. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 places. What you have to do to get your greatest 7 digit number? You have to write 7 nines. So, here we reached 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 nines. And put that unit, tens, 100, thousand, 10,000, lakhs, 10 lakhs. So, how to read this number? 99,999. So, see here I use numbers to write this explanation. Why? Because if I write 9, NI, NE, GY, so much space we needed. And here, shortly I have written 99,999. Is it clear for you all? And here we have to see your place value system. Already you have learned from the small classes you are learning. So you might have learned unit place and tens place in your first and fifth classes. And now it is extended to 100 place. Now it is coming to 1000 place. And now it is gone to 10,000 place. Now it is lakh and 10 lakh. So, this much we have learned. See how bigger this number is. So, interesting, right? Yeah, we have to see U denoted or U or O. You can write for unit, T for tens, H for 100, T T 4000, then TH for 10,000. 10,000. Now L for lakh and TL for 10 lakhs. See here, TH. This one is TH, that is 10,000. 10,000. Is it clear for you all? Yes. Now we are moving to the exercise part, that is few numbers are given here. Try to read it. So, explanation, a short method or to avoid mistake, what you have to do is, as soon as you got one number, please don't write as it is. First step, you have to give the place value for each digit. So, each digit is having its own place value. So, here I have written one number, that is 130240. This is just a number. What you have to do is first put unit, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000 and lakh. That is place value. I store up to L. Why? Because there is no other number left. So you can also stop up to lakh. Now you have to read the number. How to read? 1 is in lakh place, 3 is in 10,000 place, 0 is in 1,000 place, and 2 is in 100 place, 4 is in tens place, and again 0 is in unit place. So how to read this one? 1,30,240. So in this one, unit and tens and hundreds stay always together. And if we move to 1,000 place, we can tell 1,000 and 10,000, one family. So you can stick on. While reading, you have to read together. And like this, like that, lakh as well as 10 lakh also. So let me recall in your textbook. Let me take my textbook. Your page, textbook page. Page number 12 I am doing here. Write the following numbers in words. So it is 2nd May. Write the following numbers in words. So here they have given few numbers. Let us try to do this. So first number is 2, 3, 5, 7, 6, 5. Yes, quite big number, no? Yeah, but don't worry. Easily we can solve this sum. So, as I said, first what you have to do, write place value on the top of all these numbers. So, here you can write unit, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000 and lakh. Again, we got lakhs place, right? Yeah. Now, try to read this one. I told you, this unit, tens and hundred stay together. So, after this number, we can put one comma. And 35 stands together and lakh is separate. And this portion, it is their place value system, Indian and international, we will be discussing in another class. So here, you can read this number, try to read with me, 2,35,165. So how to read this one? 2,35,165. Now, let me see another one more number. Here it is. 7,35,05. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 digits number. So here it is, unit or one space, tens, hundred, thousand and 10,000. Yes, I told you, 1,000 and 10,000 will stay together and unit, tens and hundred stay together. So they are thick friends, so that they will be always together. So now you read this number, 73,505. So how we are reading? We are writing in words. We are writing in words. That is called as number name. So you will be getting another name. Write the number names for the following numbers. What you have to do? Nothing else. How we are reading? Like that we are writing in words. That much for the children. So we have completed 3 mains today. That means in your textbook, page number 12, First main is you are writing, write the following numbers in figures and in words. That is smallest 5-digit number, greatest 5-digit number, smallest 6-digit number and greatest 6-digit number and smallest 7-digit number and the greatest 7-digit numbers. And your second main is write the following numbers in words. And third main is write the following numbers in figures. That also easy. That means suppose you are getting one number. Okay, let me see this number only. See here, 73,505. You are writing. So I am writing first itself in your question paper or in your daily work. What we are giving? I am giving here 73,000. Okay, 505. So we are writing this one. This is called the number names of this number. Is it clear for you? So we are writing in words, and this is called its number name. Is it clear? Yes. This is how we finish today's portion. Whenever you are free, open your math textbook and solve all these sums. Spend little time daily so that you will be expert in maths. And one more thing, don't forget to recollect your multiplication tables. This year we are learning up to 12. Yes children, now we have learned the smallest 5-digit number and the greatest 5-digit number. Then 6-digit, smallest and greatest. 7-digit, smallest and greatest. Now we are going back to our 5-digit number. Little more sums we have to do. So see here, first topic I am taking here, 5-digit numbers. As we learned, the smallest 5-digit number is the smallest 5-digit number is which one? How to read this number? Unit, tens, hundred, thousand and 10,000. So here we got the smallest 5-digit number is 10,000. So like that, the greatest 5-digit number is the greatest 5-digit number is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 places are there. So we have to give 5 nines here. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. And put unit, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000. TTH denoted for 10,000. So how to read this number? Yeah, you are reading 99,999. This is our greatest 5-digit number. Is it clear for you all? Yes. Now, come back to this one. One by one sum, we are going to do it. First one, how to represent 5-digit number on the abacus, on an abacus. So here, first one, represent the following numbers. Numbers our first main is represent the following numbers in an abacus. So here I am giving first number 5, 3, 0, 2, 1. See, 5-digit number. So how to represent this number in an abacus? That is our question. So for that, what you have to do is draw one abacus. So see here how I am drawing. This is our base and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 now digits are there. So 5 vertical lines we can give like this. Next, you can write the place representation, that is place value representation, that is unit, tens, hundred, thousand.
thousand, ten thousand. So here abacus stand is ready. Now see this number. If you want, you can write the same thing here also to avoid confusion. Unit, tens, hundred, thousand, ten thousand. Now it is easy to draw beads on an abacus. See here, for unit place, how many beads you are having? This is U or O, both also correct. Ones or unit, it is correct. So how many beads you have to draw in ones column? Here it is one, so you can also draw one bead here. Now you are moving to tens place, that is two. Here how many beads you have to draw? Two. So one and two. Hundred place nothing, that is zero. So leave as it is. No need to put slash or nothing. Just leave that column. Move to thousand place. Thousand place we got three. So three beads we have to draw here. One, two and three. Last of last, five. Same way, draw five. One, two, three, four and five. This is your representation. So this number we have written 53,021 in an abacus. See how simple it is and easy to. So next number, one more practice question. Second one. 4, 5, 9, 8 and 1 or 1. Let it be 1. So same way, put unit or ones, tens, hundred, thousand and 10,000. Draw abacus stands or abacus. It is here with me and I'll show you next class that one. So here it is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 digits number. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 lines we get. And we can write unit, tens, hundred, thousands and 10,000 here. Children, here I did not mention this number once again. If you want, you can write once again this number. Here it is counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that is 5. And here it is 3, and here it is 0, here it is 2, and here it is 1. That is the correct way of doing sums. So here it is now 45,981. Next number is 45,981. So how to do this one? Same way, unit place you got one bead or one number, so one bead. Here it is 8. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Here it is 9. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Here it is 5. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Here it is 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. While writing itself, if you want, you can write the number, nothing wrong in that. So 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So here it is 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So here it is 9. Here it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here it is 5. And last number is 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. If you count once again all these beads and count, write the number, there won't be any mistakes. So it will become one rechecking for you. So two examples are given in your textbook. Many examples are there. You can practice in your rough note. So this is the first main what we have learned. Represent the following numbers in an abacus. How to represent numbers? So make sure that whenever zero we are getting in one place, we have to leave the line as it is. So rechecking also is important while doing sums. Is it clear for you all? Yeah. See, recall it. We have learned small digits, five digits, smallest number, and the greatest five digits number based on that first main we did. So six. more examples. So come back to our portion. So second main we are doing. Second main, what is that? Write the following numbers in figures. Write the following numbers in figures. So in last class we have written numbers in words. That means the smallest 5-digit number is 10,000. So we are writing 10,000 in words. 10,000 in words. So this is your question and answer. You have to write it here. So how to write 10,000 in figures? For that, first we have to write unit, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, place. If you want, you can make columns or as it is written. So better you make columns to avoid confusion or mistakes. So here 10,000 we have to write. So here 10,000. So 1,000 place we got 10. Other places not mentioned. Not mentioned means what? There we have to put 0. So unit place nothing, tens place nothing, hundred place nothing. But here it is 10. So you can write 10 as it is. Or 1 10,000 and 0,000. That also will become 10,000. So here you can write, you have written 10,000 as it is. Now write your greatest number. So greatest number is 99,999. So same way we are writing. So for easy method we can, the words we can write, sometimes we use short method. How we will write 99,000? Then 9,900. So nine hundred and ninety-nine. This may also correct, but if it should be in full words, our topic is which one? In figures. So sometimes it may come like this. So nothing is said to worry. As it is, you can frame the numbers. Or else, let me write fully in words. So listen. 99,000.
Thousand, ten thousand.
How to arrange all these numbers? Yes, unit place you got last number is 5. But observe this second part. Here what and is there, but tens place we did not get any number. So here 78,000, that is 70,000 plus 8,000 for 78,000. 78,000, that is 70 in 10,000 place and 8 is in 1,000 place, together 78,300. So 100 place 3 and 5, only one number we got it here, that 5 is in unit place. So which place is vacant? Here you have to give 1 0. So how to read this number? 78,305. Is it clear for you all? Yes. So some next remaining is what? I will be giving numbers like this in figures. You have to write in words. That is our next remaining. That we have done. One or two examples I will show you. So next one, next remaining, that is 3rd May. 3rd May or 3rd question we are writing. Write the following numbers in words. Write the following numbers in words. For this, another technical words we can use number names. Or write the number names for the following numbers. Like that also we can read. So here, writing words is nothing but its number name. So what is that? Number name means we are writing, how we are reading a number, as it is we are writing in words. That is called its number means. So first question. You got it here? 84,253. So how you are going to write this one in words? So here, you can see here, unit, tens, 100, 1000, 10,000. So, read this together, 84,000. So, you are writing P-I-G-H-T-Y, 84,000, 253, 200. This much, that is 84,253. One more question. B. Yeah, see this number? Again, same procedure. Unit, tens, 100, 1000, 10,000. How to read this one? This one together. That is 90,000. So right here, NINETY 90,000. And 100 pays nothing. So read that one. And we got it here, 73. So write that one, 73. So these two means are very much easy. That means any one of the main, if you know how to do, vice versa next one. So there is no confusion. So let us recall, our smallest 5-digit number is 10,000. The greatest 5-digit number is 99.